Hello and welcome to Technically You, the place for future technologists. I am Professor Victoria Yu Ki. If you are new to our channel, I would appreciate it if you hit the subscribe button. Today on Technically You, we will be covering virtual network functions. What are virtual network functions, VNFs? VNF is the basic block in NFV architecture. We covered what is NFV in our last Technically You video. It is the virtualized network element of NFV. In other words, it is software that performs certain network functions, for example, routing, switching, firewalling, and load balancing. It also replaces having separate vendor proprietary and specialized hardware and allows network functions to be ran on generic or commercial off-the-shelf, COTS, hardware built with different degrees of compute, storage, memory, and network interfaces. VNF can also be divided into network element sub-functions, which means that only certain functions of a router or switch are virtualized separately into VNFs but function together as an integrated network element. VNFs are software deployed on virtual machines, VMs. With VNF, the protocols associated with the virtualized function does not need to be aware of the virtualized implementation. This means, the virtualized network functions, the firewall services and routing services can interact with each other without knowing they are not physically connected or operating on dedicated physical devices. Now that we covered VNF, let's continue with the other two necessary components of the VNF layer. Element management, M. The element management system is responsible for the functional management of VNF, for example, fault, configuration, accounting, performance and security management, otherwise known as FCAPS. And EMS may the VNFs through proprietary interfaces. Just like the network functions, EMS can be a VNF and if there may be one EMS per VNF, or an EMS can manage multiple VNFs. M does the management of all functional components. VNF manager, VNFM. A VNF manager manages a VNF or multiple VNFs and is responsible for the lifecycle management of VNF instances. These actions consist of instances termination, scaling in and out, instantiation, failover, as well as coordinating and event reporting between the NFVI and the Network Management System, NMS. The VNFM does the FCAPS for the virtual portion of the VNF and VNFM also does the management for all the virtual components. Benefits of VNFs. Use of generic devices, no specialized or proprietary hardware devices. These generic devices also allow for scalability and flexibility with virtual upgrades and patching. Less devices and cabling. With network functions virtualized, there is no need to purchase and deploy separate hardware units, firewalls, routers, switch, etc., nor is there a need to physically cable them. Decrease in end-of-life and end-of-sales concerns. Organizations no longer need to be concerned with specific hardware devices reaching end-of-support and end-of-life since network functions can be deployed on generic devices. Reduction in capital and operation expense. With most network functions on a single generic device, the operations can reduce power consumption, cooling requirements, and free up physical space. Management and network configurations and provisioning are much easier since they can be done from a single centralized platform versus physical employee dispatch. This is our technical brief for today. Thank you for watching our video on virtual network function. We really appreciate you spending time with us. If you like this or any other Technically You video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel.